Hello friends, welcome to our channel. So in today's session, let us have a look on one more program, that is a simple C program to find the transpose of a given matrix. So this is a very simple thing, so finding the transpose. So first let us have a look on how to find this transpose and what is transpose. And if you consider the 2 by 2 matrix, so 1, 2, 3, 4, this, the transpose of given matrix is the rows, I mean the columns will be shifted to rows and the rows will be shifted to columns. That means 1, 3, 2 and 4. Simply we can say the lower triangle will be shifted to upper triangle and upper triangle will be shifted to the lower triangle. So here, forgetting the logic, just we will analyze this as a A matrix A of 2 by 2. This as a transpose of 2 by 2. Right? So let us write the indexes. So A of 0, 0. So there will be 4 elements. So A of 0th row in the first column, A of first row 0th column, A of first row and first column. So here it is 1, 2, 3 and 4. After conversion we are getting the transpose of 0, 0, transpose of 0, 1, transpose of 1, 0, transpose of 1, 1. So here what are the values here? T of 0, 0, that is 1, 3, 2 and 4. This matrix. Right? So by combining this, what is the 1 which is equal to A of 0, 0? Right? So what is the value of 3 here? A of 1, 0. A of 1, 0. Right? Next. Coming to this one, I mean 2. A of 0, 1. A of 0, 1. Next. This is equal to A of 1, 1. Right? If you observe here, just by replacing the indexes I and J, we will get the transpose. See, 0, 1. In the 0, 1, 1, 0 element will be saved. In the place of 1, 0, 0, 1 element will be placed. So, if you consider the 3 by 3 matrix, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. So the transpose for this given matrix is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 and 9. So if you observe, this is the 0, 0 element. So this is also a 0, 0 element. This is the 0th row first element. And here we can get the first row 0th element. Right? So here 2 is A of 0th row first element, this is the A, which is T of 1, 0, first row 0th element. And coming to the 3, here A of 0, 2 element, which is equal to T of 2, 0, C, second row 0th element. Similarly, 4 is equal to A of 1, 0 element, which is here 0, 1 element. So 0th row first column element. So simply by replacing the I and J values, we will get the transpose of given matrix. So for any square matrix, just replacing the I and J will give the transpose. Now let us write the program. So main function. Now declare 2 arrays, int
a of some 10, so we have to give a maximum number. Later in the program we will restrict it to the number of rows and number of columns. And transpose of 10, 10, here also we have to give the maximum size. So again in the later we can declare the rows and columns, number of rows and number of columns. So int rows comma columns comma index values I and j. Now read the elements scanf %d the number of rows and number of columns. So after reading the rows and columns, now read the values into matrix. So for I is equal to 0, I less than rows, I plus plus. For j is equal to 0, j less than columns, j plus plus. So I is for rows and j is for columns. Scanf %d a of I j. Sorry, ampersand of a of I and j. So here these statements are for reading the elements into array. Now we have to assign it to the transpose matrix. So that means just replacing I and j. So for this also we have to write for I is equal to 0, I less than r, I plus plus. For j is equal to 0, j less than columns, j plus plus. Just replace the I and j values. Transpose of j com j I is equal to a of I j. So this will just copy the rows into columns and rows to columns into rows. So after assigning to the transpose matrix, we have to print the same. Again write down for I is equal to 0, I less than r, I plus plus. For j is equal to 0, j less than columns, j plus plus. Printf %d transpose of I j. So if you write here print slash n, so we can get the format in rows and columns. So for after every row the new line character will be implemented. So every row it will be coming to the next line. So this is the logic, and this is for reading the elements, and this is the logic of transpose. This is the logic for display. So this is a simple program to find the transpose of a given matrix. And here we can check the transpose, we have to read the values of both the rows and columns, and then we can apply the actual function. So hope you understood this simple transpose program. So if you are having any doubts regarding this one, feel free to post your doubts in the comment section, so that I will definitely try to clarify all your doubts. And if you really think that my sessions are useful to you, like my videos and share my videos with your friends, and don't forget to subscribe to our channel. So thanks for listening and watching. Thank you very much.